Good day, Merry Meet. Thank you for joining me today. My name is Glynis, and I am the Witch of Whitetail Hollow. It's so nice to have you here today. Thank you for joining me. I've been asked by a few people about my work with Hecate, or Hecate, and I'm hoping that I can answer a few of your questions. I'm hoping that I'll get it right. Now, make no mistake about it, I am not in any way, shape, or form an authority on Hecate. But they asked me about cleansing statuary. What I would do is, and of course I don't have mine here because there are some things on YouTube that I just don't share, but as far as a cleansing statuary, I would cleanse it actually probably the same way I would cleanse virtually anything that I bring into my house. And of course, I don't know if you can see it over, I've got a big haul over there that I've got a lot of things that need to be smudged this morning before I can start using them, and I really need to get to it. But I would just smudge it, talk to it, because I mean, with the amount of people, especially if it's statuary that you picked up in at a local metaphysical store, the amount of people that's probably picked it up, touched it. Anyway, yeah, I definitely would do a thorough cleansing. But I would, after that, I would just set it on my altar and wait. And wait for a sign. But really, I think probably a full moon ritual, being a first time, if you're going to be using it, would be a really, really nice thing. And with the full moon ritual, you don't ask for anything else but to connect with Hecate. And it's all about her, of course. And that's, you know what, that's okay. She has probably, gosh, over several years been coming to me first. And I'm not the brightest, but it took me a while to get it clued in. But you know, I finally clued in on it and I started working with her. And for her, the way I work with her is she gives me strength, because I think she comes to people at a point where they are at a crossroads, and I have definitely been in more crossroads than I care to admit. But yeah, that's, I ask her for strength, because especially in my career, I'm working with virtually different people every other day or every other week, so at some point in time I may never know who I'm working with or what the situation may be. I will be asking her for something today. And again, just because you ask doesn't mean you're going to get what you're supposed to get. But I never ask for money, ever. Let's see, what else did the person want to know? You know, as far as offerings are concerned, well, when I am in ritual with her, I always do honey, bring honey, eggs, a little bit of garlic, and depending on the time of the day, this morning I've got black coffee set out for her. But I think the most important offering that you can give to her is not necessarily things that you can set on your altar. It is within yourself and what you can do. For me, ways I feel like I have given to her has been I had actually a black hound come to me at my door saying, "Help me, help me, help me." And so in that respect, I took care of the black dog for quite a long time, and when the time came where I had to move, I couldn't have her She was adopted out to a very, very happy family. And I've always contributed to animal shelters for pets in needs after hurricanes and disasters. I've always monetarily contributed. And I've always been very, very active in animal rescue. And so my offering, I think my offering of my heart and my soul has probably, she has probably appreciated more than anything that you can set here. It's the way you live your life and how you view things. Now, I have asked for good things, and you know, she, Hecate's treated me wonderfully. I have asked for other things, and the bottom line is, as far as hexes and curses and banishments and things like that, Hecate knows if someone has mistreated you and how you've been treated. And I don't say, Hecate, you know, please do harm to this person or make this person lose their job or anything like that. I let her decide, because she probably will act a lot quicker. And she knows. The bottom line is, she knows, she sees everything. So, you know, I hope I've answered your questions. And I hope everyone has a great rest of the day. I'm going to carry on with my work here. And so I'll say, Merry part, and merry meet again.